happy Wednesday to everyone and Thursday to the rest of you. How's everyone doing? Yeah, let me see. How did your update go? What is the poll? Did not do it. A lot of didn't do it and a lot of waiting for results. Oh my goodness, we've got lots of alerts. Let's see. Hold on, I can't see. The poll is blocking my... Wait! Hold on, we have a... Hold, please. Hold, please. I will be with you all in just a moment. Oh my goodness. Okay, we just had a bunch of resubs and we now have a hype train. Becca, 9 months. Becca is a Twitch baby. What? Kalava Waffle, 3 months. Happy 3 months. And GM Scott, also 3 months. Oh my gosh. What is happening? Red Linen, you're also 3 months. We have so many three-month anniversaries today. So many three-month anniversaries. 3 month anniversaries. That's hard to say. Oh my goodness, you guys. And Annie, thank you for 100 bits. Okay, I can see the alerts now. I can see the alerts. Also, Andrew, congratulations on first today. First is always like a bit of a gamble when I don't start right on time because you don't quite know what I'm coming on. So I needed some extra time to get ready because I was updating all my mods and then I needed to shower and get my hair done. And I just needed a little bit of extra time to get ready today. But we're here. We made it. We made it. You were in the shower waiting for it to start, Rebecca. Awesome. Oh, my goodness. Oh, what a way to start on a Wednesday, you guys. Wait, it is Wednesday, right? I honestly don't know what day it is ever anymore. Rose, you're debating if you want to put mods back in or just keep it the bare minimum, like more columns, cast, UI cheats, MCC, just leave it at that. I'm so sick of updating everything, and I have like three different like instances of the games with like separate mods folders, and it's such a pain in my butt. I've got my main mod, my main save updated, and I've got Wild West Decades. I have backed up all of my save files, and I have also created like a save as, just in case when we get to playing today, if it's really messy, we'll just be like, you know what? Never mind. Scrap. Scrap what we did today. I only got to play for a few minutes. Right now, I'm not on my game screen yet, but I'll show you the only thing that's messed up on my game as of right now. But I have not been into cast. I haven't fully tested. Is like, you know, up where you switch from walls cutaway and like where you save and stuff like that. That UI bar is kind of glitched out for me. I did update my UI extension cheats. All of my UI on the bottom is fine. It's just like that top UI bar is a little messed up. So that's all I'm having. I haven't played enough to know if I'm getting like a bunch of exception errors. So we will find out. Rebecca, oh my gosh, Papa Cedric, he's a blast from my Ultimate Decades Challenge, RIP Papa Cedric. Iris, you saw the live stream for a bit today and it looks decade-ish a bit, like the pack that's coming out tomorrow, is that the one you're talking about, Irish? Or something else coming out, because I'll be honest, I've never been great at keeping up with like Sims news. I just find out from the community. Moonchild, welcome in. Anku, thank you for the hydrate. And the stretch. The jewelry thing looks really decade-ish. Ooh, that's exciting. Let's do a nice stretch. And a deep breath. Oh, Gorp, you removed tool. You know what? I meant to do that and I totally forgot. I meant to log into my game. Turn organized debug off and then take tool mod and better build buyout, and I forgot. So maybe I'll do that during break, because for right now I think I can just play through it. It's a little annoying because I can't see the like walls up, walls down very clear, and I click the wrong button sometimes, but that might fix it. Oh my gosh, hold on. Anku, happy 2 months. Oh my gosh, so many resubs today, you guys. You guys are amazing. Oh my goodness. Okay, so the hairs will be so nice with Sabrina's hair. Gosh, so we're getting a lot in this pack. Like hairs, a wallpaper, gameplay, like it seems like a lot. I'm kind of excited. K Cannot wait. You're going to have to wait on your Magic Royalty Let's Play for probably a week because of broken mods. I saw that, like, Arranged Marriages is broken. Regency Romance, or one of the Regency mods, is broken. A couple of those different ones. Like, a lot of different decades gameplay mods. Just from the few that I was looking at. But, Ari, you're tired and got to be up early. It's not sure how long you'll stay. No worries. You can always jump into the replay. Plus, I have no idea how gameplay is going to go today with the update. So we'll see. If it's really clunky, then I was like, you know what? We might just end early and give it another try. I don't normally stream on Thursday, but I was like, I'll see. We might. If it's really bad, maybe I'll pop up tomorrow. If not, we'll just wait till Friday. We'll see how it goes. We will just see what happens. I loved watching the walkthrough of the pack today. I always end up just watching like a YouTuber like go through it. I hardly ever catch the like actual Sims like streams or whatever. They're usually during the day and I'm working and then I'm not able to watch them. You guys are excited about it, though. Does anyone watch Whiny Brit? I've seen some of Whiny Brit's videos. I have seen some of those. If it goes poorly, is your Magic playthrough doable? Like, my other save file? Is that what you mean, Redlin? Like, if the decade save doesn't work good? Because that's in a completely different save file. So, but there's way more mods in my... in my file for the Magic one. So I felt like that was even more of a gamble because I have like a lot of mods in that save file. We got hype train emotes. Yeah, check out Lil Simsy's review. I usually watch like someone like Lil Simsy or like, I don't know, like one of the like big simmers will like do a like review and I'll just watch whatever pops up in my like YouTube feed. Had no idea I had more than mods. I have like a main sim save that has most of my mods, and that's where my Magic playthrough is with like all of my CC and stuff. I'm not using a ton of mods, but it's like in my main game file, which is because I'm tired of having so many files to update. So I'm trying to put more of my series into one game folder with like just like one main set of mods and then only have decades split off. So that's what I'm trying to do. So anything that I do that's like modern gameplay will be in that save with like all of my mods in CC. I love that you cannot die from one of the jewelries. That's so cool. You have one line that is a daughter lineage that is witches, and that line is going to go through the Salem witch trials. Oh my goodness. Is that your decade save, Irish? That sounds so fun. It's gonna be intense. But I like, it's like, that's like combining decades and like spellcaster gameplay, which is so cool. It's so fun. That sounds so fun. Okay, well guys, let's hop in because we're already starting late today and play some decades, hopefully. Fingers crossed. Fingers crossed. Because we are right where we left off after Lucy and Eli's wedding on Monday. And so if you guys weren't here on Monday, we had Lucy and Eli's wedding. It was super lovely. They got married at the church. And we had a reception. The reception went a little rough at first, but it eventually we got them going. But she's home. Her and Eli are living in the little back house back here. Eli's passed out. He had a late night, poor thing. And they did woohoo. She's not pregnant. One of the things was I wanted... Wyatt was supposed to be starting school today. He was supposed to be starting university. And with everything with the wedding, I didn't get him enrolled. So we're a little behind on that. So that's what I'm going to try to work on today. Princess Robot, hello, hello. Welcome in. Rebecca, good night. Good night. You thought of doing the same thing since you've not played with Spellcaster Pack either, Mama Sims. I'm having so much fun with the Spellcaster Pack so far. There's some stuff I wish it worked differently. Wyatt, what's going on with you, buddy? I just need to escape this family. Well, good thing you're going off to university soon, bud. He's like, I'm ready for city life. Artman, you've been studying so much history, and it's all my fault for doing UDC. I was watching like Britain's Greatest Castles or something like that on Netflix today. That's what I did on my lunch break. I'm just like, I'm absolutely obsessed. I'm obsessed. I make history interesting. Oh, I'm glad you guys think so. I don't know what it is. I've always liked history. I've always liked it. I don't know why. I don't even know what it is that like really draws me to it. I've definitely always liked the different fashion. I think I've always just found it interesting how like people lived like before we got to where we are now. Here, Lucy, come cook something. I'm kind of scared to use. I did update Granny's cookbook, but when I did my better exceptions thing, it did give me an error. Here, come make like camper stew or something. Wyatt is definitely introverted and he's so done with the overcrowding in the house. Oh my god, it's not even as bad as it used to be. But he like, I just have a feeling like his character is gonna just like really blossom. I'm hoping once he gets to university. So he'll kind of be there like doing his own thing, and then we'll do like rotational gameplay where we'll pop in and like see how he's doing. The only thing that I'm not sure how it's gonna work is like university doesn't do super well if you're like not there to like take them to class. So I haven't really like honestly thought it through. I might even end up just like cheating his degree at the end if we don't get to like actually play out his degree. I don't know. We'll like figure it out. James is calling the chat. No, but you're welcome to come over for dinner, James. Frankie's also introverted. I could see that because like Betty is for sure extroverted, and a lot of times in relationships there's like an introvert ends up with an extrovert. Let's see, who's hungry? Mom is still passed out. Everyone had such a late night at the wedding. Okay, Dad's hungry. Eli, here, wake yourself up so you can come have dinner with your wife, but put some clothes on first before you do that. And then Wyatt, you're hungry. So call your dad, your husband. Her husband! I love that. Oh my gosh. Call your hubby, your dad, and your brother. Any other family members running around? Josie's sleeping. Okay.
Teru's
sleeping. If he isn't living in the dorms, it will send him to university. I'm moving him to the dorms. I'm going to move him to the dorms. Artman just checked out a study of history as it relates to Pluto being an Aquarius. Wanted to see what happened historically. Lots of wars. However you say the name of that. Mount, the volcano. Paper was invented. Who is calling? What the heck? Jeez, that phone likes to never stop ringing. I'm like, what's up, Lucy? One of my friends heard about how great you are and has asking. I'm going to say okay because I'm really curious who it is. Even though we technically don't have phones, we'll say, I don't know. Maybe we just ran into her out in the yard. I told you to put your clothes on, Eli. I like how Eli just took his food and left. You can send him in a dorm or a student housing. We already have it all set up. So I have it. It's university housing. I can't remember what it's called. It's one of the ones at the Brightchester school. So we had to, I don't know if you guys were here during the stream where we took him to Brightchester and he got to tour around the school. The phone was invented in 1876, which is actually exactly what year we are. But these guys definitely would not have had a phone yet. But that's so interesting that it was 1876. That's exactly where we are. Hey, this is Jake from State Farm. Eli is getting really comfortable. Oh my gosh, you guys are like merged together. Okay, William, you can get ready to go to bed because you're exhausted. Lucy, you're pretty tired. Go ahead and clean up. Okay, Wyatt, come up here and come. Let's get you going on this. Oh my god, I don't even think I've had him. No, he has applied. We just need to enroll. They for sure wouldn't have a cell phone, even with the notebook override. It's still like, Okay, Wyatt, you can have a seat, buddy. Let's. He's just gonna be a late arrival because he's starting school late because he couldn't miss his sister's wedding. So, you know, it works out. It works out. We're gonna do, the problem is I really wanted him to do economics. Yes, okay, good. I don't care if it's not. I want him to do an economics degree. I think that's what Boss Hogg is like pushing him towards. We'll see if that's what he sticks with. But for now, that is what he is gonna start with. Mrs. Hooper would be roped into being the telephone operator. One of our friends is an actual Jake from Sandbar. Oh my gosh. I could see Mrs. Hoover as a telephone operator. How many classes should I put him in? Should I put him in two just to make it more manageable? Aria, enjoy your lurk. Because if I'm not controlling him the whole time, maybe I'll do... I don't want to have to play him the whole time. I think I'm just going to cheat the degree at the end. Like, he's going to uni more for storytelling than I care that he actually checks off all of the boxes. Yeah, I have the mod for shorter university credits. I'm going to do two classes and just to test it out. Now the only problem is I don't remember which one of these is supposed to be his. I'm trying to think. They look so similar. I feel like I need to go look at it before we do this. I want to put him in the right house. I think he's in Wyvern. Yeah, let's cancel out real quick and let me go to, I got to make sure I put him in the right place. We can't put our boy, because I put one that looks kind of decades related, and I was going to show you guys when we took him to travel there, but we weren't able to like visit it. I think it's this one. So which one is, it's, yeah, it is Wyvern. That's what I thought. So it's Wyvern. Oh, but it's not going to let me with students already being there, right? I haven't done university in a really long time because I want him to have those two guys as his roommates. But gosh darn it, how does this work? You think it'll still work? I feel... Actually, you know what? It was giving it to me as an option just now. Let's just try it. We don't have to rush today. We don't have to rush. We'll just test it. And if it doesn't work, we can just troubleshoot after. But my game doesn't take that long to go through the loading screen. So we'll just hold our breath and hope for the best. Why do I need free build, Rose? I've already modified it. I've already modified it. I just meant like, will it let him pick that as his housing? Since they're like, sometimes if there's people already in that, like a household assigned to it, it like won't let you move in. It was giving that us that as an option though. So let's just see what happens. Hurry up so we can get to uni by tomorrow because the night's not getting any younger. Let's see, two classes. Should you take a... No, you don't need an elective. Wyvern. Of course this is the expensive one. He is gonna pay with a student loan for now. Okay, did I select it? Wait. Just kidding. I guess we're playing with household funds for right now. Yay, I love it. Okay, yes, yes, yes. So he's going to be living with Miles Darcy and Emmanuel Bradford. Oh, Wyatt, don't get yourself into trouble with Emmanuel, please. Because he has a crush on Emmanuel. Instantly, the second that man walked into the library, Wyatt was like, yep. Yes, these guys would like to sign up for another term here. Two classes for you. Two classes. They're all economics students. And I put the LGBTQ mod by Lupino in. It was updated today. So I don't know. We could have a play around with some stuff with that for Wyatt too. Because there's things that they can do for like coming out to people or it being like secret and stuff. Miles is who I literally created to be love interest for Wyatt. But you know, Wyatt decided... Let's have a little tour. We're just going to play with Wyatt for a little while. Then we can go back to the main household. Look at it. Wait, I thought I took that Walt thing off. Look at his dorm room. He's got this old little dorm room. I imagine. Okay, where's Miles? Miles is here. I imagine you guys can help me with the backstory, but Miles and Emmanuel are both from very like. Well, like, okay, some of this stuff in these rooms doesn't go. Okay, we don't have painting stuff. We're economic students. They're from like very affluent families, probably from like New York City and stuff like that. So like Miles, can we make Miles British? Can we say he like came from England? Miles Darcy is from an affluent family from England and has come to the United States to study and learn about the railroad companies or to work for the railroad companies. Emmanuel, where are you? There you are. Emmanuel is from a family of bankers out of New York City. And he's a little bit evil. He like literally has the evil trait, but I don't know. Maybe William can change him. So they're both from very rich families. And then this is the lot I put down. Gosh, I wish I could remember the creator, but it just had a very decades vibe to it. We might have to take little things in and out here and there. But it just had a very old timey, like we definitely don't have a microwave, for example, or a coffee pot, at least not that coffee pot. But that is the place. Let's save now that he's moved in and get Wyatt going. I can't, my controls are all messed up. Okay, cut away. Where are you, Wyatt? Let's get you all settled, buddy. What do you think of your new school? Oh, he's like, why don't you come say hi to your new, I'm gonna have to learn my way around. Sarah, thank you for the hydrate. Miles Darcy is a descendant of the Darberfield line. Lord Darberfield, I'm not sure if I'm saying it the way I'm supposed to, was his great-grandfather and a distant cousin to King George IV. Yeah, Miles is supposed to be the love interest. Miles is supposed to be the love interest. Okay, they're all running around. Wait, oh my God, he went straight to the bar. He said, I'm getting myself a drink. I'm in college now. Love that for you, Wyatt. Love that for you, bud. It's like snowing outside. It's so nice. Okay. No, you don't like video gaming. We don't have video games. We're just gonna walk through. We need some like more students though. I need to add more townies to Brightchester because with the home regions mod, oh no, we also have to set the sinks. That is not for dishwashing. These are bathrooms. Oh, Wyatt has good manners though. Okay, let me see. Where kitchen? This one is gonna be kitchen sink. Are there any other toilet? Technically, those toilets are not time period appropriate either, but for like a community lot like this, I'm like, it's fine. It's fine. Okay, what are we going to do? We got to get ready. Okay, it's only 8:45 p.m. We've got some time. I kind of just want to see what he does. Are we going to go talk to anyone or... I need to assign you guys your rooms. Hold on. Let's see if we... I want him to share a room with someone. So Let's make this you and Miles's room. So let's assign your bed. That's what happens. He becomes his bunk mate. Miles, you're here. Did I say Maya? Did I say that? The community building at Brightchester is known as Darcy's Den, so could have been gifted to the university from the Darberfield family. I love that. I think I noticed that when I was putting lots down. I was like, oh, that's what I named that sim. I was like, that's so cool. And then let's see, where will Emmanuel, maybe Emmanuel got a private room because his family would totally do that. His family would totally give him a private room, and he's already in here. So then I want to lock this for, no, lock for everyone but you. Oh my God. I don't know what I'm doing right now. Computer security, lock for everyone but Emmanuel. And then that's fine. Him, Wyatt, and Miles can... Oh, wait, are we doing their couple's name? That's what you guys are doing. I thought I said his name wrong. Okay, we're not video gaming. Where, what do we need to do for school? So this term he has to take a, submit a term paper and take final exam. When the heck did you do your homework? The language of money and building financial trust. University. We're gonna say he already had homework because he came a day late. How do I do my college homework? Do homework. Okay, let's get this knocked out of the way. And then I kind of want to just add a little bit of stuff to decorate, to like personalize it for like Wyatt's personality. Like, I'd rather change his nightstand to have like a bunch of books on it. Just things that look like they're from his like home. There's definitely not a camera. I'm just like keep finding little things that I'm like, nope, nope, that wouldn't be here. That would definitely not be here. Yeah, maybe give them two more dorm mates, and then I just need to add some people throughout the town so that way when we go down to like the pub and stuff, people will actually be here. Oh my God, Emmanuel. Oh my God, Emmanuel. No, no, no. Oh. Oh gosh.
Is Tumbula Bratzel.
Spinya.
He's describing the apocalypse.
Bouchard Bido.
Don't worry about homework. Just get started on the term paper or presentation. Once done, you can go to class and take notes. We did make Betty pregnant. I couldn't remember. Betty has gone into labor. Oh no. Oh no. An ad is starting in 4 seconds. I don't think it's gonna let me. Okay, hold on. Let's let these two talk, and then after the ad, we will go finish. We'll go check on Betty.
Bina Flim.
I usually get A's in college. I usually do pretty good in my, in uni. I'm just gonna have to, okay, what time are his classes? Oh my God, one's on Monday, Wednesday, Friday at 1:30, and one's... Should we just play where we go to the other household, but every day we have to switch back over to Wyatt to get him to uni? Lingo. I'm gonna have to like write it down. Wait, what just happened? Stop. I missed it. What just happened with Emmanuel? Because his classes are in the evening, so that's good. Because we can play the morning in the other household or whoever we want, and then we just have to switch over for his class times. Okay. So I keep clicking okay, and does that mean it wants me to switch to her? Is that what's happening? Is that what's happening? Let me get switched over to her while the ad runs, and then we'll be ready to... I'm learning how to play rotationally. We'll be back with you, Wyatt. We'll be back. We'll be back at 3 p.m. for your class tomorrow. Or 1:30. I have to look what day in the game it is. Okay, we're going back to Chestnut Ridge. Oh God, they're gonna have to I want them to move out, but I need to find a lot from the gallery for them because I don't have it in me. I think I want to move them up to this lot. No, maybe the Canyon Crossing. I want to move them up over here. So either Canyon Crossing, which is 20 by 20. Oh, God, that's actually a little bit bigger. So maybe I do move them to Canyon Crossing. Oh, no. Okay, I wanted to, RC guy, I wanted to test if that alert would work today. I can't figure out why my sound on that one stopped working on my new computer. So I'm going to turn it off. I'm going to turn it off and I'll refund you your points after stream for that one. I owe you 10 shroomies. Yeah, that one's not the daily one, but that one's supposed to play a sound, and I'm sad that it's not working. Okay, we want to play... Betty, how are you at Red Roan Field? You're having a baby. Yeah, we do need to give James another baby, because let me look at my spreadsheet. James is supposed to have... James is gonna get 5 baby tries and Betty gets 4. And then James has 2 babies and now Betty will have 2 babies. I didn't even know they can go into labor on a community lot. We gotta get home. Can you travel when you're pregnant? I don't wanna break the game, but we're not having our baby here. Oh, wait, what am I talking about? I forgot that Betty and... Never mind. Scratch everything I said about them moving to that other lot. I totally forgot that Frankie and Betty are going to move to this house right here. They're going to move here. So we need to get her home. And then after this baby's born is when they're going to decide to move. And then maybe today's stream, we can turn that into a residential rental lot. Because I would like to do that. Okay, Frankie, let's make sure you're home because... Technically, she's kind of home, but I just haven't moved them in yet. All right, let's do this. I'm so nervous for them. Honey, I was out doing some shopping and my water broke. She doesn't even look pregnant. Why does she not even look pregnant? What is happening? It says we're in labor, though. Pregnant in labor. It's go time. She's looking very good for 9 months pregnant.
Nippin Grelby?
Wobby.
Me.
Let's go. We've got a baby to deliver. Come on, Frankie. Grab Violet and let's go. Oh my God, it's like he listened to me. It's like I told him what to do verbally. Oh God, no, she's already having it. Pause, wait for us. Wait, hold on. I'm having trouble navigating this menu because I can't see everything. Okay, yeah, we'll leave the walls up. Oh my gosh, okay. She doesn't even have a baby bump. I do have a mod that has discrete pregnancy, so maybe that's what's actually happening this time. Okay, sure, Steven, you like small talk. Do you guys want to vote or bet on boy-girl? And then we'll do death rolls. Or would you rather do bets on... we're only going to do bets on either gender or death rolls. I think gender is more fun. Yeah, let's do it on boy girl. So let me get it out before she has the baby. Boy girl. Okay, 1 minute. Starting now. Yeah, gender reveal bet. They had a girl the first time. I have so many girls in my game. Like, so many girls. Let's see. How is Frankie almost here? Okay, Frankie's almost here. He's not going to miss the birth. I love that he brought Violet, though. I love that he brought her with him. And then while you guys are doing that, I will get the rules for the death rolls out. And while y'all are doing that, speaking of history, I was watching that the Britain's Greatest Castles or whatever, and in the 1500s, they said that 20% of mothers died in childbirth, and I was like, dang, the odds aren't even that high in the Ultimate Decades Challenge. I was like, I feel like we need to like raise up the percentage. Like, not in this series, because we're already in the late 1800s, but I was like, that's crazy. Like, having a baby, there was a 20% chance that, like, you weren't going to survive. What will we have? Okay, lots on. Okay, this is going to be a good payout, depending on who gets it. Okay, let's see. Let's see. Hurry up, Frankie. Get your butt in here.
Ayola.
Nanny Bell, you get yourself down here, too. I saw you standing right outside the door. It's a girl! It's another girl! Okay, before I choose the outcome, I want to make sure it's not twins. Oh, you know what, Redlin? That's a good question. I don't know. They just said a twin. There was like a woman having a baby, and they said there was a 20% chance of her dying. So I don't know if it was every time. It might be across their lifetime. That would make sense, maybe why it's so high. Okay, so baby number one is named Violet. So what should we name baby girl? Put your suggestions in. I'm gonna wait to pick the winners just in case we have twins and it's a boy too. Then I have to figure out the payout. Yeah, I was like another flower name, like Petunia. I was about to say Petunia. I was about to say like Petunia. Lily. I really like Lily. Lily, Daisy, Petunia. Okay, I'm gonna put the like flower names into a poll real quick. And their last name is Mayfield. So that like, the name, like the flower names like are really pretty. Lily, Daisy. I'm trying to see through chat. Petunia. Okay. I've picked five. Okay. Starting poll. They're all so cute. They're all so cute. Oh, that's so cool. I didn't know Stream Elements would pop the poll in chat. They all sound so cute with Mayfield as the last name. That's a cute name, Redlin. I just feel like I wouldn't be able to say it very good. I don't keep a spreadsheet with names. No, I always just go whatever one I'm feeling like in the moment. Usually when I used to just play on my own before I was on stream, I would like open up websites and like read name meetings and all of that kind of stuff. And like really like for like my main character sims, not like every single sim, but I would like my names to have like meaning, especially for like my founders and stuff. I'll add it to the spreadsheet. It looks like Lily's probably gonna win. So I'll start adding it while the poll finishes. And then it's 1876. Oh my gosh, we have now 4 grandbabies. Okay, so let me pull this over. So I think Lily, let's see. Yeah, Lily won! So we now have Lily Mayfield, daughter of Frankie and Betty, Gen 3, female born in 1876. 1876 was like a big year for the Wild West, actually. Why does this color look different than the other? Wait, what is going on here? I will figure that out later. It looks different. Okay, we're gonna have to do death rolls and stuff first. So let me select this, and then I can do the payout if this is the only baby. Oh, thank God. All right. Oh, you guys, I'm curious how much y'all are gonna get paid because you guys were the lower of the bet and it was a good split. So let's see. Complete prediction. Okay, you guys should got your shroomies now. Love watching the genealogy videos, the Who Do You Think You Are series. Ooh, I haven't seen that. 1876, hold on. Summer of 1876. There's like a whole book. There's like a whole book on it, on the summer of 1876. So the summer of 1876 was... So it was the release of Mark Twain's novel, The Adventures of Tom Sawyer. It was the inaugural baseball season of the National League, the final year of President Ulysses S. Grant's embattlement administration. And then there was a lot going on with Wyatt Earp, Crazy Horse, Sitting Bull, Bat Masterson. There was like, I don't know who all these people are, but if you're curious about it, just look up the summer of 1876 and you can read some of the history. But it's like a lot of the like really big moments of like the Wild West, like all happened that summer. She had a negative sentiment. Oh no, she doesn't have the like hates children trait, but she might have the does not want a child right now. Yeah, I kind of want to take that off of her. I'm going to take that off. I don't want her to have that anymore. Who is she distant with? Childhood phase. This teen has become distant. Being near and interacting with family has started to stress them out. Well, I can see that. Maybe she kind of had a falling out with them after she got married. I can see Betty not being like overly maternal, but I don't think she doesn't like hate her children. Okay. We've got to do our death rolls now. Our little cute baby. Did you take the picture or not? Yeah, you did. Okay. Okay. So we'll do Betty first and then baby Lily. So let me bring these up. We're not going to do bets on the death rolls. So D100, this isn't the wheel I normally use. So it's only, I think, if she rolls a one. It's only a 1% chance, but still. It like... still makes me really nervous. Okay, 47. Betty survives. I want to get my other wheel back that I used to have on my old computer because I like it better when it spins. And then, let me see. Do I still have my command? So newborn. Newborns have a 20% chance of death. They do not survive if they roll a 2, 6, 10, or a 14. So, okay, it's going to load. This doesn't count. So that doesn't count. And then we'll roll... okay, well, we can see it. So what is it? 2, 6, 10, or 14? Yay! Oh, my God. I always get so nervous. I forget the numbers. Yay! Lily survives. I think we should go ahead and do the infant roll while we're here, though, because we're going to have so much going on with Wyatt. So infants are 3, 9, 11, and 15. So let's roll again, holding my breath. Yes. Okay, so she's gonna be good all the way to an infant. One scares me all of the time because one is death for mothers for a lot of stuff. Whew! Yay, we have another healthy baby girl. Love that for us. With the new pack, if you are wearing a specific jewelry and it's the one linked to the Grim Reaper, you're pleased to save will always succeed. Ooh. That is interesting. Maybe we can have one of the Sims get into jewelry making. Maybe like Josie grows up and gets into jewelry. Or maybe, I don't know, maybe even Betty. I don't know. We'll see. Aww. Yay, we have a new boo. Oh yeah, I always try to click on the baby and I forget that you have to click on the crib. Here, come feed. Let's do, okay, yeah, prefers breastfeeding. Go feed the babes.
So.
And then show off to Frankie. Like an inherited magic necklace. It could be really fun. Violet, come meet your new sister. Oh my God, this is such a cute little moment. They're all coming in. I love it. Grandma, up. Up, up, up.
Krita Flimmabor? Huh?
Let's see, are you gonna show off? Yeah, show off to Frankie. Frankie, come meet your daughter. Uh-huh. Oh wait, she went to sleep. Sorry. You just look at her. Hi, Grammy. What else can we do? Babble? Oh my god, yeah, babble about sibling. Or here, just snuggle. Snuggle with your Grammy. They're so cute! Okay, we're gonna get you guys moved out of here in just a second. Selling and making jewelry for Josie. They're so cute. Aw, Violet just became good friends with her grandma. Not boss. If... excuse me, this is kind of a family moment, Boss Hog. We named the baby girl Lily. Her name is Lily Mayfield, and she survived both her newborn and her infant death roll. Yeah, this was the moment that they said, we've got to go. We've got to go. We can't raise our two children in this shoebox of a room. There's a new selling table that comes with this new pack. What don't we get with this new pack? I'm so impressed. And David Salvatore girl, hello, hello. Welcome in. Sorry, I was like all over the place. Your bed is less stinky and doesn't have Darla. He's just laughing. Betty, no. No, 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 no. Betty, you need to come wake this man up. I'm sorry, but, yeah, Betty's over it. You've got to... Oh my god, he got right back in! What is going on with you and Darla, mister? I think the beds maybe got unassigned whenever I, redid the save file. Boss Hog, you definitely... You sleep up here, buddy. Darla... You know, I realize Kirk doesn't even have a room. Kirk doesn't even have a room. This house is gonna need a makeover, but it's fine. I was not planning on them having children, but you know, I can't help it. Okay, Betty, we will get you out of here, sweetheart. We are gonna get you out of here. Yeah, boss, you have a very posh upstairs. Exactly. He drank too much and is confused. Oh my gosh. Okay. Otherwise, the family is being super cute right now. Okay, Betty, you can actually go to bed. You just had a baby. Get you some rest. Frankie and Mom have got this. Why don't we put our baby Violet to sleep? Here, Frankie, why don't you tend to your wife? Good night, little bean. Aria, thank you for the hydrate. It's fine, Kirk. We're gonna say that we let you come down here and play because your parents don't pay you any attention. Here, Darla, you go to bed. Is there a big light in here? Why is it so bright in this room? I don't know. Whatever, we're about to move them out. I guess he's a Boy Scout. I don't know why he's wearing that. He's supposed to look like Boss Hog. Let me show you his actual outfit because it's quite cute. He's a little mini Boss Hog. Although this is not Boss Hog's biological child. He is the child of the outlaw. I have a feeling he'll be more important later. As he gets older.
Oh, poor
Zabrazy. He's just a little side character for right now. Seeing we have shoved Sims into the basement, we make an attic and put the kids in the attic. Okay, so let's go ahead and leave this household so we can break up. Let's see, oh good, we've only been going 52 minutes, good. Let's break up this lot, Rose's amazing lot, into, where is Darla's other baby? Was he in the household just now? Did he accidentally get yeeted when I like moved them over from the others? I had to rebuild my save file. So residential first, and then like save and leave and come back, Rose. And then save it to gallery just in case. Okay, yeah, just in case. What was that sound on my computer? Can you guys hear that? I just had some sort of like alert sound that I have no idea what it is. I don't even know. I guess I don't know if you guys heard it though, because I don't have all my desktop sounds running through the computer. It was weird. Okay, save this to the gallery. You did hear it? I don't know what that was. That's the sound that goes from day to night? I've never heard that before. Okay, let me save this as Redrone Field 228.24. I'll just save it to my library. Save new. It was like a chime, kind of like almost like a phone, like when you get like a text message or something. I don't really know how to describe it. Okay, so that's saved to my library just in case. Do I need to leave the lot and come back, you think, Rose? What would you do? Yeah, Darla did have a little redheaded toddler, and I'm gonna have to check and see if he accidentally got deleted. We can change it now to rental lot. Okay. Residential rental. Let's make... walls up. Maybe this one can be unit number one, because isn't this like the nicest one of all of them? Because there's how many? This one's pretty nice too. Yeah, maybe whoever runs like the cafe is the main lot. So this will be unit number one. I did this in my Ultimate Decades. I turned a lot into and then for the businesses to work, we can actually use Little Miss Sam's live in business mod. I think we'll make it work the best. And then if there's a fenced in area, okay, this one didn't turn into a room. If it turns into a room, you can actually make the outdoor area like all part of their house. Did I do the outhouse? Yeah, I did. Okay. Rose is such an amazing builder. My stuff's always so square and just like boxy. And you're really good at like using all of the different spaces and having like more dynamic like floor plans and stuff, I guess is how I describe it. Yeah, we'll use live in business and make it a cafe, because I'm thinking we'll move a family in here that will like run the cafe. And then I want to see if we can get this restaurant working. But I don't know. We might just have to continue to pretend. So what I'm going to do is make, you don't have to make it a shared area. Well, I'll leave it shared because it works either way. I tested it in Ultimate Decades, whether you make it part of the unit or shared, it will work as a live-in business. So actually, I'll go ahead and just make it one. Like, everything will work. I was so surprised when I tested that. It's a lot easier to run it when it's assigned to the household that owns it. Unless, No, the funds will go. So the problem is if you make it shared, the funds will go to whichever family you have open it. But if you assign it to the household, it'll like It's weird because it, like, even if you're, it's not set as one, it lets any family open it. It's weird. So I don't know. I'm going to leave it like that. I haven't play tested it in a long time, so there's been a lot of updates since then. Let's make this one 2, and this is where Betty and Frankie are going to live. This is going to be such a cute little place for them. I think that's all I need to set. Whoops. I think I got all of it. Okay. I guess I could set the porch. I guess no. Because then I don't know if the porch, if like it's not shared, if you, I don't know. I don't know if it does anything weird. And then this one can be unit 3. This is going to give us so many more places to put Sims because I want more townies. And then Rose already has these like decorated and ready to go for like families. It's perfect. 3. It's fully fenced and you can lock the gate. If it's like fenced and it makes it a room, it actually lets you pick that area as part of the unit. Like, let me see if this one does it. Nope, this one doesn't do it. I don't know why. It does. It just depends on how the fencing is like connected to the unit, but we can lock the gates once, like you said, like once Sims are in there. Okay, I think I got all the rooms here. Is, yeah, 3. Okay. And then isn't there one more? Yeah, up here. So then this one will be for like a little, it's not really a studio, a little one bedroom unit. Yay! And then everything else we'll leave shared for right now. We will add 1 red roan. I want to add live in business. Dang, Rose, did you do this? Wait. Oh, never mind. It's just my UI is messed up. I thought every single lot trait was on this house. I was like, what is happening? Moonchild, random question for everyone. Does anyone else's sim say something's dirty when there isn't? They have been lately. And also, do you have like a teapot or like a kettle or like a Instapot thing like in your game? Because those are like spoiling and your sims are saying something's dirty. But I got rid of my teapot and my Sims are still saying something's dirty. And I'm like, you're crazy. There is nothing dirty. Oh, I didn't mean to get rid of that. We'll keep that. I just want to put the live in. I'm just having some UI problems. But I want live in cafe on this one. Okay. Save. Have wild prairie grass. I can put that one on unit 2. It's the diapers in the Christmas tree. Your Sims just moved in their 1620s hovel and they're already saying that. Ugh. Don't you love it when you build a house and it looks like immaculate and they're like, I detest the decorations. And you're like, you know what? You know what? I didn't ask your opinion. I think it looks great. So, nope, that's not what I want to do. Why can't I not get back to, okay, whatever. Wild prairie grass. Oh yeah, right here. 2. Oh, that's a challenge. Wild prairie grass, there we go. Okay, we can add more later when my UI is not messed up. I'm having trouble seeing with my UI. All they have are those straw beds. Everything else goes outside, so it's completely empty. My Ultimate Decades Challenge, they don't even have a real floor. It's just dirt and straw terrain paint. So I had to turn it off, bust the dust, because it kept getting dirty and they can't sweep it because it's not a floor. Okay. So now we should go and have Boss Hog buy the whole property. So Boss Hog like owns all the land. and go from there. Kiera, welcome in. How are you? How are you doing? We're just having slow gameplay today. So we got Wyatt moved off to university. Betty had a baby and the baby did survive. And so we're getting Rose's lot set up to move Betty in and we're breaking it up into rentals. Moonchild, you're going to build a new house. Let's see. So Boss Hog. Are they working, Amanda? I knew that they were supposed to fix it, but I haven't played enough yet to like see if it like truly got fixed. Move them in, go to manage families. I've done this before. I just want to have Boss Hog own the property first. Boss Hog, wake your booty up. Wake your booty up. Buy this land. Poozin, welcome in. Am I saying your name right? Because that's how I always say it. And I never say anyone's name right. And that's probably not how you want it pronounced. But it sounds fun when I say it. You love custom holiday making, especially for decades historical challenges. I need to get better at holidays for my historical gameplay. Because I do a lot more holidays in regular gameplay. Bye. Residential rental. Here we go. Oh, Ina. Katie Cakes, it's updating. You're scared. Mine's not too bad. I have some UI stuff. So like up here, my UI is a little bit messed up. But I think if I take out Tool Mod and Better Build By, that will fix it. But otherwise, so far, we haven't played a ton of gameplay to know. But we were able to have a baby. So that's good. That's like a big thing. But I haven't tested a lot of gameplay stuff. Okay, Chestnut Ridge. By Red Road Field. The thing that is annoying that I found though, like with what we're doing right now with the residential rentals, is it is very difficult to unlink it all. So like if you're like, I don't want this to be a residential rental, it's like you have to do things in the right order or stuff gets stuck. Like certain things you have to be in the household to edit. Some things you can only edit from the world menu. You can't do this unless the person sells it. Like you get like in a situation where it's really hard to undo it. So that makes sense, Rose. Like if we want it to like go back to it not being a residential rental, we can just download it from the gallery. That would be good. Okay, so he owns this now. I don't think he needs to do anything. I think it just loaded us here. Because Boss Hog doesn't care. Boss Hog's going to be the most inattentive landlord there ever was. Ferret made things so complicated. Wish it didn't buy it sometimes. Definitely more trouble than it's worth. It's like it's got its pros and cons for sure. It just doesn't work the way I think we all thought that it would. Amanda, you're waiting for the updates. I do not blame you. Boss Hog is like, yeah, all right, you can leave my house, but you're still gonna fatten my wallet. He's like, yep, here you go. I'll put you up and I'll get you guys started. We're gonna move them in with free real estate cheat because we're gonna say Boss Hog was like, look, just get out of my house. I'll get you guys set up. Like they don't own it. They're renting it, but they didn't have to pay anything to like move in. Oh God, this is taking a while to save. It's making me really nervous. Okay, so let's go back to, nope, not the gallery. I can't see my menu. I just wanna go to manage worlds. Mish, welcome in. Hello, hello, hello. I feel like we've been going so long and it's only a little past an hour. I think it's because we started late today. So we would have been right around an hour and a half right now if we would have started on time. So now we want to... Ugh, this menu is driving me crazy. Manage households. Yeah, that kid is gone. You guys weren't wrong. I bet they got opened in CAS. I bet I accidentally opened them in CAS with How much money should we give them to get started? I don't want to give them very much. Maybe like 5,000 simoleons. We're going to move them in. We're going to give them all the furniture and stuff for free. I have not decided what they're going to do for careers yet. No. But I kind of see, like, they're not going to have a ton of land. They're not going to have a ton of land to have, like, a bunch of animals or to do, like, a ton of gardening. Maybe, like, odd jobs around town or something. Like, I don't see them ever being, like, super wealthy. Unless, like, Betty gets crafty. You never know. Okay, I want to... I have to read because, like, my icons are all messed up. Move into a lot. I forgot. Their unit 2 is the one I want them in. This one. Daily rent 73 simoleons. Oof. Yeah, that money that they just got would be coming from Frankie's family. Frankie would work in the bookstore. Yeah, like, I feel like they would have jobs in this little area. Like, maybe Betty works at the cafe. Maybe Betty, like, makes some extra money, like, working at the buffet. And then we can move a cute old lady in, like, maybe across the way who, like, maybe, like, helps take care of the girls. Or, like, I don't know, maybe Madison comes and watches the girls while Betty goes and, like, works a little bit at the cafe. Yeah, the barista career for her to start to, like, make it like she's going to work at the little cafe. Okay, can we load into their house real quick so we can make sure that we have the right age furniture for the kiddos? I'm so happy for them. I really wanted them to have their own place. Yes, and we need to add the Undertaker. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, Boss Hogg's dropping us off in the middle of the night. He was like, here you go. Here's the key. Can we handshake? Hold on, actually, let's have Frankie do it. Why is handshake? Do I not have my greetings, Mon? Oh, well, whatever. Aria, thank you for the stretch. You can't finish your watercolor.
A bunch of Clodazoid.
All right, let's get your kiddo. Let's go see if our babies. See if our baby's over here. Yes, Aria, let's do a quick little save. And I moved the baby with us, but I'm gonna have to find the... Oh, the crib is that annoying crib. Okay, we're gonna... I'll probably after stream, I'll do a little bit of, like, re-maneuvering of stuff just to make it work for the age of the kids that they have. Are you care? You did... You were supposed to bring your child... You were supposed to bring your child.
Yeah.
Violet. Dad's coming for you. You're daddy's girl anyway. Yeah, the baby will age up to an infant today, so we'll just probably go ahead and age her up. Because we know she survives. And now it's the next sim day, so she'll be on track for her birthday. So why don't we go ahead and age her up and give her a little makeover real quick. So then we don't even have to reconfigure the house. I hate this crib. You, like, can't see the baby in it. Betty, no. Come age up. I figured today would kind of be like a bit of a save file maintenance day. Oh no, Violet is going to find the well if they're not careful. I know, we're gonna have to childproof this place. I need to get them in and lock this gate. This gate is so cool, Rose. Which gate is this? Okay, we're gonna... Oh! No, 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 no. We're rolling again. Okay, I'll take Wiggly. We are not having intense. I'm sorry. Another redhead baby girl. I mean, it makes sense because they're like both redheads, but that's Betty's red hair as well. I love that. Okay, get rid of this god-awful thing, please. Yay! It's from Horse Ranch. I haven't used that one yet. It's so good. It's so, so, so good. You can add the bottom bed to their inventory, and then we can put the put the toddler bed there. Perfect. Good thinking, Rose. Let's do that. Lily, you're so cute. I want to give you a little like bow in your hair. Yeah, like that. She's cute. I'll give her a little, like, red eyelashes. We did. We rolled for the newborn and the infant at the same time. So she lived. So we will roll again when she's a toddler. For infants, I just have, like, a little dress that I, like, put them all in, to be honest. I kind of want to do this one just to match her little bow. That's like so much more medieval. That's too fancy. I'll just go with the yellow dress. She has Frankie's face. Yeah, I see it. And she got, Betty's hair color, which I love. I'll just give her a white dress. Okay. I kind of want to leave the little hair thing on her. Oh my god, that's cute. It's not like my infants are not time period appropriate, and I don't spend too much time on it. If we have, like, a specific event, we can, like, give them some makeovers if we need to, but I just don't want to be here for 20 years. Can you have that little thing on your head again? Because it was, like, adorable. Like, so adorable. Yeah, they don't stay infants for very long. You're so right. I'm trying to get back to her socks. Her little, there we go. Her little socks. All right, Lily. And then let's give your sister a toddler bed, and then they're ready to rock and roll. And then I think we'll take a little break, because when we do like a lot of prep stuff like this, I start to get kind of, whew, it like makes me kind of tired. And then we'll get back into gameplay. So let's just put this one in inventory, if it'll let me. Oh, it's going to be kind of slow because of... Yeah. We'll give them some animals while we're in their household. Okay. And then let's grab a little... I haven't been in build mode yet since I updated, so it looks like it's okay, because I technically still have Better Build By and Tool Mod in, and they're not updated just quite yet. What about the little pink bed? What about that little pink one like that? And then the infant can stay there. And then they just got an extra bed if they need it. So we'll get chickens and a goat. They've got some garden stuff going. They've got Do we have a hamper in here, Rose, since the laundry thing is out there? Or do I need to give them, cuz we could put a hamper right there. Yeah, I'll put a hamper in so it doesn't like pile up on the floor. Wait. Am I in trap? Aren't hampers under? Where is the Lily's palace? Here it is. We'll put the Lily's palace one there. And then I'll put them in a real clothing line that they can use for laundry. I'll put this for the fireplace too. This is like the thermostat. I'm gonna size it down one though. That'll be the thermostat. And then where is, oh, I think that's under outdoor activities, isn't it? The actual clothesline. Yes. Okay. So they should be able, I think they should be able to get to it right there. I think they have half a tile. Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. They can get to that just fine. It's like so small, but so cute at the same time. Like, it's so, so, so cute. Oh, we already have a high chair. Love that. I think they've pretty much got like what they need, like just to get started. It can evolve. We can like make it a little bit more like specific to them as it goes along. You've playtested every home rose. Of course you have. Yeah, the wood is a thermostat. It's like a piece of custom content. Do I need to add anything for the Todd, like blocks or anything, like for her to maybe have some like skill building? I can maybe put her blocks by the end of her bed, because you'd be surprised at what they can reach, because those don't have a footprint. Do I need a toddler potty? I could put a toddler potty. Where's the new one from For Rent? Actually, I feel like they would have like a little wooden one. So I'm gonna put it there because they'll be able to reach it. Some blocks on the front porch. I didn't even think about utilizing the porch rose. That's such a good idea. Ooh, whoa, I did not mean to do that. I just like spun that sucker all the way around. She can like play with blocks right here while mom's like out in the garden. Oh my God, the details on this, like, hold on, let me make it sunny outside. Like this like pail hanging over that. Like, did you tool mod that? Wistful! Welcome in! Okay, so she's got potty, some blocks. I think she's good. We'll give her a little teddy bear. Because she can put that in her inventory. She'll put that in her inventory, but that's her little teddy bear. I give that to all my kids. Knitting stuff for Betty. She's got cross stitch out here. But I like giving them that one in their inventory. That's like just like the ball of yarn, the custom content one. This one. Betty likes green, so I'll give her the green one. She can put that in her inventory. Okay, I think they're good to go. Wistful, how are you? How are you doing? I miss you. I haven't been able to hang out at you guys' streams the last few days, and I feel like I don't know what's going on, and I miss everyone so much. Yes, let's assign their beds. Unit rating change. Why did our rating change? I'm not really worried about the For Rent features, to be honest. Oh, this lot's taking a lot longer to save because now it's a rental. Maybe Betty can get into nectar making for the town saloon. I could see that for her because I can see her being a little bit more in sort of a non-traditional path. And like she would know how to do that because William did that while she was growing up. So she's like seen her dad do nectar making, and maybe he like teaches them how to do it to get them into doing nectar making. Okay, you don't have to assign the Todd, but you need to go to bed. And then here. Feed. Ageless hippie, welcome in. We're both hippies. Hi, hello. How are you? Welcome in, welcome in. I'm Shay. If you're new here, welcome in. She doesn't strike me as a housewife. Exactly. Exactly. Yeah, she doesn't want to be stuck in the house at all, no. Aww. Okay, so we'll get them going, and then I think we're about to take a break in a few minutes. Change that diaper. That girl is... And then we'll get in a groove after break.
What's up, Jay?
And baby bartending. Found me on a search for Sim streams. Wow, that's crazy. I'm so glad you found your way in here. We are a cozy, chaotic community. A little bit of cozy, a little bit of chaos. Just depends on the day. We play a lot of Decades Challenge. So I don't know if you're familiar with Decades Challenge, but we play a lot of Decades and some stuff that's not Decades as well. I'm doing like a Spellcaster Challenge right now. And we just vibe. Saturday is going to be our 1 year celebration. I've been streaming for a year and all of the things. Okay, put this baby to bed. Oh, I did forget the animals. Thanks, Rose. There's too many things going on. Okay, get these children to sleep. And then, let's see, where is... Okay, we've got a coop. So let's just get them a rooster and then a hen of every description. And then, how do I buy them a goat? Can I do that from here? Oh, I got them three hens. I got them three hens. You want to try this challenge? Decades is so fun. And if you ever have any questions, I highly recommend our Discord. Our lovely community have like uploaded so much custom content. We all, not all of us, but a lot of us love Decades. So like if you're just starting, like we can just answer all your questions. Because I started super simple and over time it's gotten to like full-blown like CC mods, all the things. Where are you going, honey? Eat a ham and cheese sandwich. Where? I'm gonna cheat your hunger. How do I buy a goat? Isn't there a board out here somewhere? Rose, direct me. You built this. Like, I know it's out here. Buy goats. Okay, buy a little... Just the cheapest one. A little white sheep. Here, yeah, the little cheap white sheep. And here you can get a little gray mini goat. Oh, the hay feeder was another option. Okay, I couldn't remember. It's like, since I stopped to play to move, I've like forgot how to play the game. Like, I have literally forgotten how to play the game. So place and world. Let's lock this for all livestock. Lock for everyone but household members. And then where is the hay feeder around here? Oh, we have a bee box. Oh, here's the hay feeder. Okay, we've got the hay feeder right here. Okay, I just gotta orient myself, and it's dark. Starting this gameplay in the middle of the night was like kind of tough. Wait, where did she get... Betty's been canning. Betty has 12 jars of tomato sauce in her inventory. Does she get into canning? That was unexpected. The chickens are gonna pick the locks. Ooh, I didn't do chickens. Does livestock apply to chickens? Just in case, lock for all chickens. Okay, save. Let's get ready to do a break. Cause my brain is like, ugh. I'm like, all this like... I used to do this kind of stuff off cam, but we've got to get these families moving along. Here, we can sell. They can make some money from this stuff in their inventory. She already had a thing, a knitting, a ball in her inventory, so I'm just going to get rid of this other one. Okay. Ooh, Rose did amazing. I can't wait to see this. We're gonna wait till the sun comes up because Wyatt doesn't have class until like it's Tuesday. I think his Tuesday class was at 1:30. So we'll just play in this household until like the afternoon, and then we'll switch over to Wyatt for for his first classes. and do a little bit of his like term paper, and then maybe go back to the main household. We'll just keep circling around between all of the houses. Is the train still puffing? You know what? It should be, because this is the version of it that I uploaded to the gallery. Yes, it is. Hold on, I gotta get it from an angle where you can see. There you go, you can really see it right there. The train is puffing. That's a little trick Rose did with the fireplace. And oh, it's so cool. So the train, look, let me put the walls up so we can like really appreciate everything. Like the little train station right here. Like you go in there and you can catch the train. I just love it so much. I didn't have the patience to try to do it. Rose tried to tell me how to do it, and I was like, yeah, I don't have the patience to try to do that. But I'm so glad that Rose did, and it looks amazing. Okay, let's get ready for a break. I need to like get my eyeballs off the screen for a few minutes, and then we'll come back and we'll get back into actual playing. So let me see, music is ready. I will see you guys in just a second.
Thank you.
Welcome back. That was perfectly timed, Aria. That was perfectly timed. Oh, did you guys have a good break? I was like half a song longer than what we sometimes do because I ran and got me some chili and it was spicy. I didn't eat it all though. It's still sitting over here. But it was delicious. Rose, I will definitely add some townies. So we'll add the Undertaker and then I'll think of some fun characters like who would run the cafe. And we'll move them in here. They'll have some kiddos. And then I think the other lot had space for kids too. So two like families and the Undertaker. Got your tea and your blanket. You're ready. I love that. I didn't make tea tonight because I'm almost out and I wanted to have tea for tomorrow morning. And Costco, you guys, I'm having a crisis right now. Costco does not currently have the chai tea mix that I buy, and I'm very sad about it. I'm very sad. I'm going to have to like find a replacement if they don't have it anymore, because that sometimes happens with Costco where they like stop selling stuff, and I'm like, no, not my chai tea. Amazon has it, but it's like $27 for a bag, and it was like $12 at Costco. I'm like, I'm not paying $27 for the exact same product. Like, why is it so expensive on Amazon? Like, it doesn't make any sense. But it's just chai tea mix. I'll just find a different one. It's fine. But I was like, I'm sad. I'm real sad about it. So I'm like, I didn't make any chai tea for stream tonight, and I'm like feeling it. I'm missing my tea. Okay, let's see what's happening. Frankie's just like out. Frankie's just out enjoying. He's like, he can't sleep, you know, just had a baby, just moved into the new house. He's out contemplating life. Like, what am I going to do? Like, I need to start making some money. Oh, goodness. Okay. What? I wonder what career I should. Should I just. I feel like I should just put him into a rabbit hole career. Thanks for including the funeral director. D Sims made him, and oh my god, he's so good. And it was all like really Rose's, I think, original idea, because Rose built the lot with the different caskets, which this one's for Boss Hog. He has pre-purchased his. Yeah, just a rabbit hole one. Yeah, so we'll get him going. He's just out here. I love this because now they've got the activities like that they can run around to do outside of their. Oh, I'm going to need a lock. Why is he trying to go into the other unit to use the sink? I'm going to have to make sure like doors and stuff are locked. I'm going to have to like figure all that out. We'll kind of figure out how to play on this multi-unit lot together. Here, I'll have him come sit and like, oh, I wish that newspaper mod from Ravishing worked so he could find a job from the newspaper, but it's okay. We'll have to pretend he's looking at the newspaper or something. Here, come look for jobs. Have a little seat. Here, light the fire so we've got some light in here first, actually. Oh god, Rose, is that gonna burn the table down? I don't know. Let's hope for the best. And let's find you a career. It's so cozy in here. And when we come by, all the cousins will be there. I love it. He's got his little notebook, the override that I have for the phone, so it's fine. I don't have custom careers. Maybe he could go into. I do have a couple custom careers just from the mods that I have. Working for the Granite Falls company, you'll start taking care of mental but necessary tasks around the port. Maybe not fur trade. Frankie looks mysterious with his hat over his face. Comedy? Gardener or retail? Actually, let's do gardener and we'll say that he like goes out and helps like he's more of like a rancher kind of a person. Where is gardener? Why can't I not find it? They're in ABC order. Oh, it's literally right there. Yeah, let's do Gardner to start. I can see that. Basically like a ranch hand. Red Lilin, enjoy your lurk. Purchase seeds, get a start on your... Rose, you got this like ready to harvest. We're gonna get some ingredients. Purchase seeds, not cannabis seeds. Let's just do some like starter vegetables because that's his task for his job. Okay, done. Maybe he can get promoted quickly. And he can also help raise... Nope, don't go harvest other people's gardens. Just your own garden. And then here, come milk the goat. And here, we'll shear this one for... We'll give Betty the wool. Here, shear for wool. And then go take care of the animals. This is such a cute... Wrong kind of gardening! I know, I forgot to put base mental in. I was like, whoops. Nope. Not this family. Oh my god, are we gonna shear the goat inside the house? That's fine. How are our babies doing? They're doing great. Oh, that one's getting kind of hungry. Alright, it's a little messy, Frankie, but it's fine. Oh, I didn't realize, Rose, that you had the, I'll replace that. I'll move the thermostat one over by the stove so that I don't have two of those objects. I'll fix that later. Okay, let's go do the chickies. I love this yard so much. It feels so realistic. Yeah, we need to give James another baby too. We're gonna play till the end of the hour. So we'll go, I've gotta keep a close eye on the clock with Wyatt being at school to get him to his class. And then at some point we'll go in and get James pregnant again. Cause I don't think we've done that yet. Here, go wake up. Oh no! Oh no, she went on the other side of the bed! I'm gonna have to move that a little bit closer to the wall so she doesn't accidentally... I did that in my other house too. Here, go wake up your mama because you're hungry. I was gonna have Frankie do it, but it's so much cute. One of the things I can recommend, if you start to get bored with your kids and your gameplay, play from your children's perspective more. Like, play as the toddler, like, going wake up their mom and, like, stuff like that. When I started doing that, I started having a lot more fun and my children started feeling a lot more real versus always playing from the the grown-ups. Mommy! I'm hungry. She's, like, straight to the toilet. Did I? Well, you know what I meant. Like, give James his family like a baby. I just meant like his family, not like James literally. Here, oh wait, you're already going. Put her down. Okay, put her down. And then give her. Why don't we do some applesauce? You guys can tease me all you want. Frankie parenting level 2. Love that. Okay. Come serve up scrambled eggs with bacon. Why not? What are you shaking your head about? Go use the toilet. Oh, he's changing in Cass. Yeah, wouldn't that be something? Where did this come from? Oh, wait. Oh, wait, he couldn't put her applesauce, so he gave her a sandwich? No, no, no. That wasn't the plan. I wanted you to have this. Well, I guess it's fine. We'll put it in the fridge. Come let out. Where's she going? What is happening? Why is she doing that? That counter was right next to the stove and completely functional. Sims sometimes, I swear. Yep, Sims being Sims. All right, I'm not gonna stop her because then it's like, here, hurry up so we can get back to your house. Why? Oh god, and now it's raining. She's not even dressed for the day. We'll just pretend like that didn't happen. Oh no, Lily's gassy. I hate that trait. Okay, actually, let's set the sinks too. This one will be... Oh my god, Frankie's like dad of the year right now. Bathroom and kitchen. Thanks, Frankie! I'm gonna cheat Violet's energy because we like moved in middle of the night and she didn't sleep well and I can't deal with that right now. See, she puts the food down right here like... He's gonna eat the applesauce? He's eating the applesauce. I just made you breakfast! Here, let's go feed the babes. Here, before you do that, why don't you invite over your parents to show them the new house? Because we've got time before Wyatt has school. I just want to see Madison and... We're going to invite our parents over. How we have to baby gate Sims all the time, for real. You'll take Gassy over Snuggly Sleeper? Really? What does Snuggly Sleeper do? Hates being put down. Those are rough ones too. Yeah, that's true. If we travel to Wyatt at least an hour before his class to allow time for him to get there. Okay, perfect. So his class is at 1:30, so we need to switch over actually in 2 hours. So we might not have a ton of time to like do stuff with the parents because that 2 hours is about to go by real fast. Did that toddler literally just whip out an umbrella? Did the sheep just scared her? The sheep just screamed. What is happening with my toddler? I love how she's gonna be a little farm girl. The first thing she did was come out and talk to the plants. Here, come. I love making them get really cute with the goats. Okay, why is she whipping out an umbrella? That's new. Feeding Tinkler? I don't get that one a lot, but I think that's because I get girls all the time, and I feel like, do only the male Sims get that? Oh my god, please stop with the with the glitching. Hi! This is so cute. This is my favorite thing to do, is have toddlers play with the goats. It's literally like my favorite thing to do in the game. Here, go play with the rooster. Okay, we've got 1 hour. We gotta switch to Wyatt. Are you taking care of the baby? You're doing amazing. Change that diaper because she just used it. I thought, did we not invite over Madison? I thought we invited them over, but maybe we didn't. All right, we could just, that's fine. That seems acceptable. You need someone to make a debug lot for the ranch stuff. Need a windmill and a rusty truck. There's, I have them turned into functional items. Oh, that's not what I'll have to give that back to them. I did not mean to delete the actual garden. My bad. I got a little click happy with my destroy object. Sorry, Rose, I didn't mean to delete the garden. Okay, let's save. Let's go ahead and switch over to Wyatt before I delete more objects that I shouldn't and I get distracted and we don't get over there. You're on Xbox and it won't debug. Oh no. You're doing a Mayflower Decades. It's been so fun so far. Not used to rotational in Sims 4, so it's been a new challenge for me. Same. I just started playing rotational for this new generation. I don't have any like specific like how many days I play before I switch. Like some people have like strict schedules. I just go with based on what's going on with the storyline. And today's stream is the first time where we have like quite a lot going between the different families. So I'm figuring it out too. But I like it because then I get to keep up. We almost started this challenge at the Mayflower, but then I ended up deciding to start it later in the Wild West. Yeah, do you guys like the rotation? I feel like you guys have been. We're getting a groove. One, I haven't played the game in 2 weeks, so I'm a little rusty. And then two, I'm kind of getting in the hang of switching. We're just getting ready for class. Wyatt's got his first class of the day. Excuse me, Emmanuel. You cannot be walking around the dorms like that. Wyatt will not be able to handle it. Betty is now closer to her family farm now. She is. You like it? I have a great cast of townies and extended family. It's great to spend time with them. I like it. I love this family. We need the eye candy. Okay, are you almost ready? Let me make sure. Oh, man, I was wrong. His class isn't until 3 p.m. Okay, I'm going to have to literally write down Wyatt's schedule. I was worried that today was his 1:30 class, but it's his 3. So let's go ahead and get started on his term paper. He was researching genealogy. What did you want to know about? He's researching this guy's family. That's what he was researching for genealogy. Let's get started on your term paper. Should we go and make a flirty comment to Emmanuel first? What are your whims? Tell a joke. Yeah, go. Let's go tell a joke. Can you tell a dirty joke, or is that only when you're flirty? Joke about body hair. Go do it, Wyatt. Let's go. He's probably going to be so awkward about it, too. Aria, thank you for the hydrate. You just like took his seat. Just clip and paste it to a note as it changes each week. Yeah. I mean, I just need to like know it like in real time, and then once it changes, then I'll just update my note.
Janine. Ruth, good day.
Tell an urban legend. You heard this place is haunted. Like, in the late 1700s, a guy, like, died in here. I don't know. What's the urban legend that we're telling? Why is he embarrassed? Awkward encounter. Is he nervous around us? Okay, he had to leave for class. Amy! Hold on. I have to pause for this. Had to pop in and say hi before I go to bed as it's my cosmic Twitch anniversary. Happy 4 months, Amy, and I hope you have a good night. Thank you for popping by and saying hi to us. I miss you, Amy. I've been gone too long. I mean, I've been back for a few days, but I just feel like I've been gone forever. Nope, we're not playing video games. We need to start on our term paper. This isn't your room. I don't know whose room this is, but it's fine. You can stay here for now because this is where we are. University, coursework, term paper. Write your term paper. Let's work on this while we're here because you have class in a couple hours. So we're just going to type away. Oh, hi, Miles. Oh, God. Mom wrote us a letter. What? Excuse me, Mom. We've been thinking about trying for a baby lately. Do you think we should do it? We want to, but we're not sure it's a huge responsibility. No, 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 I don't think it's a good idea, Mom. I don't think it's a good idea. I think it's a terrible idea, actually. I do use shorter credits to graduate, and I'm also not worried about him having to do all of them. He's at university more for storytelling. So if I have to, I will just cheat his degree at the end of this week, depending on how the storyline goes. It's like, yeah, Mom, you have like 4 grandchildren. No, absolutely not. Is there music playing in this room? I was like, what is that? What decade am I on? We are in 1876, so we're playing every 4 days is a year. She wants a Winterfest baby too. Miles, hi Miles. I'm just gonna pick interactions that are Wyatt's class starts in an hour. Let's complain about our professor. Maybe it's like a really tough professor and we're really nervous about our class. Yeah, I have the mod that makes it shorter and okay, get to class early. Yeah, let's do that. Let's get to class. Let's go. Let's go. We can't miss our first. Why can't you? What's the problem? Why can't we go to class? Where is class? Go to class. Where are you? Is he like in your way? Are you like stuck in this corner? I think we were literally stuck in the wall. It's fine. It's fine. I have a mod that's faster run to university, so he'll be fine. He'll get there. It doesn't start for 15 minutes. Yeah, we're fine. We're there. We're just waiting for our first class. Hold on, Wyatt. It's first day of school. There we go. Our university kid. The first Westbrook to receive a higher level education. I can see it. I do see Madison. Now that I'm looking at him. Oh my gosh, look who happens to walk out of class right as we walk in. Oh, hi, hello. Hello and goodbye. I wish you would have left your outfit on that you had on. Okay, take notes, buddy. Take notes. Hi, Emmanuel. What are you up to? Here, let's take you to go do something. Maybe you're gonna go... Here, let's go, like, have a little seat. Let's see. I gotta get some more townies in this world before next time. Ooh, who's this? Oh my god, I told you this place was haunted. There's literally a ghost here. Hi, Josie. Who are you? Actually, we wouldn't... Emmanuel would not just go up and introduce himself to someone, honestly. I want Emmanuel to kind of have like Chuck Bass vibes from like Gossip Girl, or he's just like, I don't know, kind of like that, but like kind of different. He can go and learn skills from the student building. Sit in on a skills class. Addicts Anonymous homework. What the heck? Charisma. Go work on your charisma. And then how long does this class... This is the worst part, is like just the rabbit hole of waiting. When does Miles have class? Miles has to work on a presentation. I should probably just work on all of that stuff. Our responsibility fell out of range. What? No! Let's come get us some food. Actually, I don't think we can cook here. And I deleted the microwave. Can we have a quick meal? Here, come get you a ham and cheese sandwich. Let's go. Let's get his term paper worked on before we leave. You have to go to Darby's. There will be food there. Is that this one over here? Wait, hold on. I put a lot down for this. Peekaboo is raiding me? Wait, what is happening? Peekaboo, welcome in, raiders. Welcome in. Hi, Abby. First time chat. Welcome in. Nice to meet you. Peekaboo, what is happening? This is backwards. You're always on after me. I'm so confused, but I'm so happy to see you guys here. What's up? Welcome in, raiders. How was stream? What were you guys doing? Did you have an early stream today? Welcome, welcome, welcome. Becca, hi! You guys were early today. I I was like so surprised. I had to like read it three times. I was like, wait, does that say Beckaboo? I was like, I'm usually raiding into you. We're backwards today. But thank you for raiding me and for bringing your friends over. How was stream today? What were you guys playing? I've missed so much. I'm behind on so many of you guys' streams. I like feel so out of the loop. I've got to get caught up. I'm going to binge watch. Let's see. We're at university with Wyatt right now is what we are doing at the moment. Rags and building a house for mama. I love that. I love that. I want to visit this slot real quick because I put this down from the gallery. Here, Miles, why don't you come with us? Noticed a lot of the clothes in Crystal Creations today work well in decades. Everyone's saying a lot of the stuff will work really well in decades, and I'm super excited to check it out. Wait, who are you people? Okay. I have no idea where these random students spawned from, so I'm going to have to give people makeovers. But I was really... Dinner... Oh, okay. Dinner's about to open. Dinner is not open yet, so we'll just come have a little seat. Miles is showing us around campus. Because Miles is a year older than us in school. Like, ignore the non-decade characters. Yes, so Becca, catch up. Betty had a baby girl named Lily who survived her newborn and infant death rolls. We moved Betty and Frankie and turned Rose's build into a multi-family lot. So they moved in over there. And Wyatt officially is starting university. So we're just playing where we have to hop over to Wyatt when he has class. So he just went to his first class. We're going to get like some dinner for him and get some of his term paper stuff out of the way. And then we'll play in the morning at the main household, I think. So we can play Lucy and Eli a little bit. Or actually, before we do that, we might hop over to James to get James pregnant. Here, actually, I'm going to just cheat that because I don't want you to go to a non-decade bathroom for right now. And then, is this going to open at 5 p.m.? Because it's literally 5:30 and it's not open. No one's here. Why did that not work? We have happy mothers and babies. Yes, they're safe and... Gotta head out. Good night. Thank you for hanging out. Hoping paycheck comes early tomorrow so you can get the new pack, mama. Yes, I hope that for you too. Wait, is there a debate happening? Okay, hold on. I'm trying to get this kid fed and there's nowhere to buy food in this whole university. I thought this was supposed to be fixed. Beckaboo, we were just talking about that earlier. I'm so glad that I'm playing with all of them too. It becomes a little bit more chaotic, but it makes it more fun because then I know like what's going on with everyone and no one gets like left behind. Why is it said, first it said dinner at 5 p.m. and now there's nothing's happening. Another option for food, or you could get them a buffet table. That is a cheat way to get food in their dorm. Yeah, we'll just, he's reading, reel her in. I don't think so. Here, let's just go home because we got to get your homework going. That's the most important thing. Running around campus. This honestly feels like probably what it's actually like at like your first day at uni. Like you don't know where anything is. He's like running around from like building to building. He's like, where do I get food in this place? Like dinner was always just served and on the table for me every day. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know where to go. I had a mod for a little while that let you actually put like cook food in university. Real life, uni life, right? So we'll just get them. Which buffet? Come on, search bar. Because I also have some like custom content ones that might work. Like, will these ravishing ones work? Because then I can just put it in the counter. But I can't remember if that's actually functional or if that's just to look like a buffet. It's the only thing. I can't remember. It might just be for looks. It says mod. Let me go into live mode real quick. No, I can't click on it. Okay, so that one's not gonna work. Where do I find the other one? Is this what you're talking about? Anku, you got your food? Because this is what was not working in the... The only university gameplay you've done was a single mom that had a very chaotic experience. I've done... I'm trying to think. When I was very early on to playing Sims, I played a little bit of university. Thank you, Beckaboo. I hope your errands go smooth. The one, oh, you were talking about the one from the Wedding Stories. Okay, okay, okay. Then why don't we put it like here? That'll be easier to find because I can just filter by Wedding Stories. I was wondering if that's the one you were talking about. I always forget what kind of pack my Wedding Stories was. It was a gameplay. Let me get this play. Well, let's get into live mode, Aria, and then we'll save. So let me... Ooh, that's... I don't know... It's not gonna look super correct, but... Just delete out the kitchen and just add a table for them to sit at. I just don't feel like doing all of that right now. I'll mess with it later. We've done so much prepping today. I just want to play. And then I can tweak it. We're figuring out what works and what doesn't work. And then I can like drop into like really fine tuning it. Here, let's have some duck. It's kind of fancy for their first day. Wyatt, why are you dancing, buddy? We've got to turn that off. Let's go get some food. Yeah, I'll work on it off stream. Right now, at least we get it functioning. I mean, I could have just cheated his hunger, but... Oh, we're going to have to figure it out eventually. I'd rather just put the mod back in that lets them have a stove. Lord Miles is used to eating duck. He's like, wow, this is delicious. We're gonna say they have like a butler basically who like works here and like serves them really nice food. Like he is in like the nice dorms. Like he is in the really nice dorms with all the like rich kids. Like Boss Hog hooked him up and got him all situated. Okay, so then come here when you're done with that and then let's do your term paper because that is what's most important before we leave. Where is my man? Okay, did you have another class? What's the old Emmanuel up to? Here, you can go home too. Whoa. Okay, where's that food? Y'all come have dinner. Our boy's doing his homework somewhere. There he is. Where is this radio? Get rid of that. They were enrolled in the same degree. She was a pain to get her to study. The boyfriend was all studies. I've done university a couple times and I always have an A student. I've had one where they lived on campus, and I did one where I played in Del Sol Valley and like had her just like go to school from Del Sol Valley, and she lived with a roommate. That was one of my before I streamed. I had a lot of fun with that save file. I had her working in the AM, the early shift as a barista, going to class in the afternoon. She'd have to nap because she was so tired every day. Yeah, radios only in the common areas or they will not sleep. See, while he works on his term paper, let me go delete them from the bedrooms because that is always a nightmare. Turn that off. Okay, so this is common area. That's fine. Okay, I think they're good. So I think they can actually have... So this is Wyatt and Miles' room. This is Emmanuel's room. So there's two more beds. I can give them two more flatmates in just this building, and then I need to add, like, I don't want to add, like, too many characters because he's not going to be at university, like, that long. But I might leave him... Oh, Emmanuel! What do you want? What do you want? Get to know... This man, like, is really taking an interest in us. Claim to be a criminal mastermind. I don't know if that's the best idea. I'm kind of curious what would happen if I flirt. I don't know what I set his, like... I don't think he would just out and flirt yet. I don't think he would just do that yet. Here, tell a joke.
Quimba. Fweezark Barangi.
Galbania in Subadibo.
Oh, my. Why are you so tense? Oh, criminal presence. I don't know. Yeah, I'm not sticking to history super, super tight. I think this dorm will be male only. I don't know that the university as a whole is male only. So maybe we do... I haven't decided how he meets his wife. So we have... Okay, Wyatt has finished a draft of the term paper. He continued to edit it or turn it in as is. Okay, so that's good. We can have him edit it like tomorrow or something. Here, how's school spirit? I don't know. Be that guy. Aria, thank you for the stretch. Everyone have a big stretch with me. Yeah, maybe Drake Hall can be the girl dorms. I love that. I love that. Emmanuel is like cute farm boy in the city. I'm just wanting to see what kind of happens with them autonomously. Because Wyatt very, like, does he still have the crush or did it, like, what's it called when it goes away? Okay, the crush thing did go away because he was just, like, gone for so long. I kind of want to add it back, though, because of, I don't know. Compliment his... Here, just flatter. We're not full-on flirting, you know? We're not full-on flirting. I could copy this building and put it over the other one. That's a good idea.
Yibs! Uh-huh!
We're not in the Wild West, though, right now. We're in the city where it would have been much more covered up. This Brightchester cheer could end any time now. It would be great.
Shabini. Quinarb. Roots of Fennel Yachts.
He's bad news, Wyatt. He's literally evil. You need to go for the other guy. See, I told you, he's mean. Why do we have to apologize? We're not the one who was mean. Show up your muscles, Wyatt. Your muscles that you don't have. I think Wyatt is kind of innocent. I wouldn't mind him going through some kind of drama. I just gotta think about what it'll be. I need to clear this notification wall. Okay. I don't think I really want to play through the night. Wyatt just got gaslit. Poor Wyatt. Actually, why don't we stay in this household for just a second so we can, like, appreciate this world? Isn't there, like... No, you can't go there. Okay, where all... There's, like, a spot. I saw Ocean Sims when she played in this world. There was, like, this really pretty little spot. She took her sim. Where's the center of the university? Okay, center of the university is here. So you can go out here, but there's no, like, where to sit or anything. Okay, where's our building? Right here. Maybe he just comes down and has a little... Wyatt's a big thinker. There's a little beach you can swim in the river. Wait, what? I like that little spot when we were staying at the townhomes. I think Wyatt goes and does a lot of, like, late night walks. Because, like, he lived on a farm, right? So he gets to, like, go and explore now. Yeah, this world is really nice. And I knew it would be perfect for, like, this time period, kind of. Is it in a different neighborhood, Rose? I don't think it's in... Oh, wait. Nope. I found it. So we're gonna explore the world with Wyatt. Like, Wyatt's never been here, so we're gonna explore it with him. Yeah, he needs some fresh air. I hate how the camera jumps, though. I want to be on Wyatt's level. Okay, and we're back. It's so nice. I can hear the crickets. All the ivy on all the buildings. Ugh. I, like, never went to a big university. I lived at home when I went to school. And I always wanted this. I think that's why I don't like biking around. If you guys have learned anything about watching me play, I like watching my Sims, like, run around through the world. I don't care for it to go, like, super fast. Is it cold? It's cool. It's day 3 or 4. But does he just, like, risk it and just goes in the water anyway, even though it's a little bit chilly? I think he does. I think he's, like, a little bit homesick, a little bit excited to be here. He's just gonna do it. He's gonna go for it. A little night swim. It's the country boy in him. Do a little back float. Wyatt's just living his life. In real life, I think the bike would be nice to bike around for sure. I just don't like the bikes in the game. He misses the pond. We should dig that when we leave and see what we get. Maybe we get a little souvenir. This is so nice. The stars. All the trees. Oh, I love this. Could you imagine living in that house right there? Oh, that would be so nice. Backed up against this pond. Ooh, that's really pretty over there. Where'd you go? Where are you, Wyatt? You're getting away from me. Oh, you are already doing your own back float. All right, buddy, you... Let's breathe! Thank you, Anku! We gotta get this boy home. He's tired. And then let's do a save check. It looks so nice at night, too. All right, let's get you back to your dorm. But dig this up first, see if we get anything good. I love how he just, like, stripped down to his underwear, because, you know, that's realistic. He wasn't really wearing anything. For modern gameplay, it's fun when they have an aqua zip in their pocket and they zoom up the river. Oh, I didn't know you could do that. Oh, you thought it would be the song Just Breathe. I just have an audio from... What did we get? I didn't even see. A hip to the max cardboard dance floor. And a fire opal. We could save that fire opal. He can make a necklace. You want to want Wyatt to stay here forever and become a professor. I think I wanted him to, like, write books. Here, put your clothes back on. Wait, whoops, not go home. Sorry. Put your clothes back on. And let's go home. There is definitely a party happening somewhere. Is that just the sounds when you're walking through the university? Like, it sounds like a party. He could be a romance writer. I could see that because he's already been writing. He actually has the best-selling author. He's already written one book, and I want him to write two. Oh, I love how he's like so exhausted. Okay, I'm gonna make you just slightly less tired so you will stop walking like that, please, hopefully. Or not. Okay, yeah, thank you. Why is it jump up between this building? Oh, it could be a sports event at the auditorium. I wonder if it was. Come on, let's get home. What's going on? What you thinking about? The sulk walk back to the dorm is relatable. I totally feel that. Ageless Hippie, thank you for 100 bits. It's usually next to the swimming hole. So maybe that's what it was. Because I was like, I hear stuff that sounds like a party. Okay, I don't remember which bed is ours, so go to sleep. I gotta fix my UI because I can't see which one is cutaway mode. Nope, not the gallery. Okay, there we go. Struggling today. Oh, Miles is already in his... Okay. Yay! First day of uni! He did it! And he got his term paper started. Miles' class starts in an hour. All right, Miles, you go get yourself to school. Let me see. Let me pause here. There's 20... I'm going to go for 20 minutes because I'm going to just go to the end of the hour even though we started a little bit late today. So to end... do you guys want... Would you rather just keep playing Wyatt through and get him through like another day of university? Or we can go ahead and just leave him from right now. Go start a pregnancy for James and Kiona and play a little bit in James and Kiona's house because we haven't seen those kiddos in a few streams. Because since we did Eli and Lucy's wedding last stream, and then that way we got to see like all the kids except for really Josie. But Josie, we'll get to her as she starts to age up. I think we go over to James and Kiona for the last 20 minutes. Is what I'm thinking. And we can play with I need to check actually even before we switch over. Yeah, let's go to James. Well, actually, let's switch over first because the thing that I can't remember, because they had the first grandchild, so when James Jr. ages up into a child, I feel like should be coming at some point. So let's switch to them. Ka'ua! Ka'ua aged up. So we have to do a death roll too. Oh no. We have to do a toddler death roll. I knew someone was aging up soon. And then we've got to get them toddler. Because we got to get him his little curls back, too. He had the cutest little curls. Look at his little outfit that he aged up in. Well, let's just have them actually woohoo and see if they can actually get pregnant on their own. Where's Kiona? Of course. She's over here. She's cooking something. Of course she is. Here, James. Oh, no. This is not off to a good start. This is not going well. Oh no! James, do something! I don't know if I'm gonna give Darla back her kid. That's not like a main part of the story, so I might or I might not, because I've gotta make a lot of townies for the downtown lot and for Wyatt's world, so honestly I probably won't. Love that Dakota and James are jokesters, but we are having a fire! And it is very loud. It's very, very loud. Here, just replace that. Yeah, he was just so casual. He was just like, no big deal. I've got this. Out of the way, Kiona. Let your big, strong husband protect you and put that fire out. Look how proud he is. That man. That's William's son if I ever did see one. Yeah, we can say she sent him off to boarding school or something. It's funny because he was also like Boss Hogg's biological child, and maybe she like sent him off because she didn't want a biological child with Boss Hogg. Okay, let's figure out what's going on with everyone else, because okay, let's start with Kua. I'm sorry, Kua, but no one is exempt from their death rolls, buddy. I'm sorry. No one is exempt. Let's see. Let me pull up what the... But they only do death rolls to toddlers. So once they... If they survive up to Todd's, then they're good. They're good to go. It's just when they're young. Do you guys want to bet? Do you want to bet on live or die? And then even if someone does save a life, it's still, I will award it out based on what the actual roll was. So even if you save him, if he rolled to die and you bet die, you win, if that makes sense. But it's up to you guys. Because chat's pretty quiet right now. So if you guys don't want to bet, oh God, I did not mean to put, did I just put us in slow mode for 10 seconds? Because I did not mean to do that. Let me turn that off. That was an accident. Sorry. Yeah, let's bet. Okay. Yeah, even if a few of you guys want to do it, we'll do it. Start prediction. One minute. Starting now. So it's 20% chance. Wait, oh, the thing didn't work because I wrote toddlers. It's just toddler. Okay, so it's 15% chance of death. They do not survive if they roll a 5, 10, 15, or 15. So it's a smaller percentage chance than the infants or the newborn. So it's only three numbers. So fingers crossed, because we've only had the one death so far, which was Lydia, the one baby that was born when William was at war. And I love this child, especially once we give him his makeover, hopefully. And give him his curls, because his little curls were so cute and I love him. I don't think I spelled his name right either. Let me see. C-A-U-A. I did! I spelled it right. It just has a little, I forget what you call the thing above the, which letter has it? The A at the end has like the squiggle. That is not the appropriate way to say that. I hate that I don't know what it's called right now. All right, lots of bets on Liv. So, what is it? 5, 10, or 15? Ah, 4! He survives! That one was close, though. That one was close. Ah, Moonchild, I forgot we still had that sound. That was a good one. That's a good time to use it. He lives! We love that! So, let's go in real quick, because I want to give him his curls back. How long has he been aged up? He's been aged... I don't know. Ooh, we've got his emotional stuff. Why can't I get into Cass? Wait, is what called an what are you talking about, Rose? I do not know what you're talking about. Did I say, sometimes I forget what I say 5 seconds after I said it. Okay, let's fix your hair, because you had cute curls. Do we have one with like longer curls? I need more curly options. It's like the... Because it was like a little more wild. Oh! Yes, Rose, I already forgot about... I was talking about that. I was like, I don't know what you're talking about. I was like, an omelet? Oh my gosh. Tildy, I think is how they say it, is the thing I was originally thinking. Maybe I just make his hair kind of wild because I picture it being like really curly and wild. So I think I'm going to do this. And then as he gets older, we start to kind of tame it. But I'm going to go with that one because I've never used that one before. And then let me see, what did I use for James's outfits? Just his regular. Okay, I used that. Okay. What a little cutie. I just need more children custom content. Yeah, I think we just do the same as what we did for James because it had the best color palette. James Jr. is the real cowboy here. Can he grow his hair long like his grandfather when he's a child and have it in plaits? That's what I'm thinking for as he gets older. So for right now, it's kind of like wild and growing out. And then it matches kind of what he looked like as an infant. And then as he gets older, it'll be in braids. So we'll just do those. I'm not going to do all his outfits right now because I have a lot of cast and build stuff to update after. So we'll just get him like his sleep. And then right now it's still getting a little bit cold. I thought I had a little pair of boots. Whoops. There we go. Those kind of match. He's got your morning bed head. I kind of want to see what he looks like, though. What if he had a little cowboy hat, too? Oh my god, they're so cute! I didn't give him his eyelashes. Their eyeballs are always way too big. It's like so unrealistic. What a cutie! Okay. Oh, I just noticed he got silly and angelic as his traits. How cute! Can see him a mix of Native American, white American long braids, but with a cowboy hat. Aww. Have a hard time putting shoes on your sim toddlers because most toddlers in real life, you know, hate shoes. That makes sense. Actually, for his everyday, what if I did make him barefoot? Because he could just be running around. And for cold weather, he's got little shoes because it would be like cold outside. And then I haven't done his other outfits yet, so... Rose, the thing's already gone. It's just automatic, so the ad's gone off already. What a... Wait, why do you... Oh, that must be... What outfit category is that in? Because that is definitely... Oh. Formal? Why are you in your formal? Why are you... Yeah, I have it auto-scheduled now, so we don't have to do it. And then it'll, like, auto-say how long it is, too, if it's a different amount. Look at him in his little bare feet! I love that we did that. And then I think we just need to plop down really quickly because they both have infant beds. So just plop down two toddler beds for them. Toddler potty. My words have not been wording today. You never put shoes on them till they are kids when playing decades. I never put shoes on my infants, but I realize I do put a lot of shoes on my tods. So it kind of makes me want to not do it as much because honestly, the shoes look kind of ridiculous. Kids, toddlers. Am I filtered by something? My wedding stories. Okay. I think I want to give them this custom content one that I've got because it kind of goes with the vibe of their house. Oh, wait, they already have a toddler potty. Okay, they have a toddler pod. They could have some, like, blocks that they play with out in the front yard or something. Maybe they both play out here. Maybe they've got... I want to give them, like, the Bigfoot-looking stuffy. And I just shrink it down one. Where the heck is that? Right here. I want to give them this. A gift from Madison and William. Madison and William gave them a stuffy. I already replaced the grill. Yep, Teddy is for sure from Grandma Maddie. Absolutely. I need to, like, make this house over more. I built this so fast after stream one day. I want to, like, rework it a little bit. Right now, I've just made it, like, functional for their house. But it needs some work. It's very bare bones. And then let's have them. Oh, she's tense. Honey, let us take care of that for you. Let us take care of that for you. Where'd you go? Where are you? Where is my wife? Oh, here she is. Oh, wait, wrong sim. Hold on. No, not your mother. Your husband, please. She's taking her stress off with some bows and arrows. Oh, sorry. I forgot to choose the outcome. Thank you, Amanda. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Yes, we got Liv. Okay, sorry. I got distracted. I got so excited that he lived and we started making him over that I forgot to do the prediction. Get your butt over here, James. Oh, well, I didn't even have to cue this up. They're just doing it on their own. Alrighty. I was gonna cue them up, but James understood the assignment. Yeah, the toddlers had one already. They've got a potty right there. James was like, "All right, you're not gonna tell me twice." Where's my babies? Here, you come play. Go stack blocks. And where's your brother? Come stack blocks together. Or you can watch Grandma in the garden, because that's also extremely cute. Oh, I just heard those fireworks go off. How'd you do, James?
Bonsa.
How'd you do? We don't have a toilet. Go take a pregnancy test. We need to know right now. The lot looks so fun with the pond and the crops. I love this lot. I just don't like how I put the house down 100% yet because I did it so rushed. But if I spend a little time on it... Oh my gosh, she's so glitched in this outhouse right now. Kiona is not pregnant. Oh no. Okay, here, come make up some dinner and we'll try again. Let's do some bison stew for dinner. Here, we'll just get rid of that. Aw, look, James being like a good dad too. Is this the horse grave? Yeah, that was the horse grave. Look at our boys. They're so cute. How is Kiona only level 2 cooking? James again! I love it out here though. I don't know. I've got to think of some ideas of like how I want to... I looked up some images of some like little houses and so I use that as my inspiration. But I've got the inside is just like not great. Good night, Amanda. Do you have work super early tomorrow? Because I know I think... Well, today... I was going to say the weekend. Today is not the weekend. Feels like the weekend for some reason. My days have been so messed up since moving. Go ahead, grab some foods. Wait, what? James is already an adult. I have it where they turn to being an adult when they're 30. So I make it they're a young adult from age 20 to 30, and then they turn into an adult, and then they're an adult from 30 to 50, and then they're an elder after 50, is I think how I said it. But James just aged up. We missed James' birthday. I think I might change that and make it 20 to 40 is a young adult.
Bye, Mom.
Because it always seems too soon. I'm like, wait, what? We're an adult now? And I'm 34, and I definitely don't feel like an adult. Okay, hurry up and eat your dinner so we can try to woohoo again. I can't believe he's already 30. Now that we're like playing through the different households, the lifespans, because originally I wasn't going to track the lifespans anymore, but now I think I might let them play out their full lifespans. Because like Lucy, she went all the way to the last day of her birthday. Wyatt, I have to double check Wyatt because I think, is he still a teen or did I age him up? I don't know. I have to check. I'll have to do like a, I need like a, just a day to like get into the save file, look through the spreadsheet, see how the time has been passing, make sure everyone's on track for where they're supposed to be, all of that good stuff. I need to do some like some save file maintenance. Here, come woohoo with Kiona again. And then if she's not pregnant again, then I need to check my fertility stats. Let's try again, honey. I'm ready for baby number 3. We've got to have 6 kids. Rose, you don't feel like an adult yet either. I feel that. I'm like, I don't know when it's ever going to happen. I just don't think it's ever going to happen. I have days where like stuff happens and I'm like, oh, I'm definitely like not a child. But I'm like, I don't feel like I'm like a super adult either. Wyatt and Lucy are only 1 age apart in game. I aged them up to teen at the same time. Oh man, the sound effects on this are like a little bit more than I'd like to hear. All right. Pregnancy test. That was really fast. I was about to say. She's not pregnant again. Okay, I've got to check. Because since mods updated today. So should be set to individual, which means I need to go. Where the heck? I thought there was one that literally said fertility. Pregnancy status. Lucy's not pregnant. They did try once. I think I'm gonna hold off because I want them to travel. Oh wait, reproductive health, fertility status. This is what I want. Set fertility rate. Okay, so her fertility is set to 21. I think the way the rules are written, I based it off of what Morbit uses for the ultimate decade challenge. I think it's in here somewhere under relationships. Yeah. Risky woohoo percentage is young adult. See, young adult would be 25%. So that's what I'm going to set it at. She was at 21, so she wasn't that far off. But Jesus, I mean, I was going to say she got pregnant the first 2 times, but we set them with MC Command Center. Try one third time's a charm. Third time's a charm. Let's go. If not, I'll just set it with MC Command Center. But I would like to have them have, like, you know, one real go at it. Aw, it's Uncle Dakota. Look at the boys are just talking his ear off. And then one, let it rip. This is so cute. Oh, he's just gassy. That was so cute. Them just like talking his ear off. Oh, are we done? Girl, we're gonna have no money left after all these pregnancy tests. Not pregnant again. Okay, I think something might be conflicting with my mod update today. So that's why I wanted to have her try again. We'll just set it with MC Command Center real quick. Because, but I need to definitely make sure something's not conflicting so we don't have to do this every time, but. Okay, I have to do it really fast. Pregnancy start with James. I don't want to see what it is. Okay. We're pregnant now. Baby number 3 is on the way. Here, go get you a nice soap, Mama. You deserve it. Let's do milk, honey, and oatmeal. Like a nice skin nourishing. I love Ginger Surprise. I don't like ever picking them. You know what's funny is I was saying I almost always have girls, but with the babies that I did for MCC, well, that's crazy. Betty had two girls and James has had all boys. Where are you going? Are you coming splashing this? No, you're not. No, you're not. You're coming watch grandma. Over here. Come waddle your little bum. And then let's see how close he is. He has 4 days until he ages up. What they're naturally eating. They are definitely Westbrook with the toot toots. You're not wrong. You're not wrong. Okay. Actually, I think we're going to wrap up because I was watching the time that we've been streaming and then I didn't realize that we're like actually after 9 o'clock. So I want to wrap up because I've got to like get my dinner, finish eating my dinner and get stuff going. But we got her pregnant. Wyatt's at university. Betty had another baby. A lot more happened today than I realized. All I knew what I wanted to do was take Wyatt to university. Yeah, I very much have work tomorrow. I have... this is one of our busiest. This last month is like our busiest of the year. Twice a year we launch. Like I work for an online business coach, so she only sells her services like twice a year. And so it's called a launch. And like for 4 weeks, we're like marketing and selling her programs. And this week is when we're selling. And it has been really, really busy, like really busy, like the worst time of the year to be moving into a new apartment. It's been insane. I'm exhausted. It's been a lot. So, yeah, I've got to get some rest. And my apartment is still like not put together at all. And it's very stressful. Tell my boss I've got a whole town to run. Yeah, like it's not easy. Like I'm playing God, you know, like for multiple universes. It's not an easy job. It is not an easy job. So anyways, she actually got me a cup for Christmas. I've showed you guys on stream before that said like, sorry, I can't. My Sims family needs me. So she like knows I stream and like all of that kind of stuff. But anyways, well, let me just take a quick peek and see if anyone's on. But seeing as Beckaboo rated me, that is who we've often rated. Okay, literally not a single person that I follow is online right now. That's just insane. That's insane. No one's on. So I think we'll just end tonight. And I'll let you go and get your rest and get cozy or do your thing. And I'll be back on Friday and we'll check out the new pack. So hopefully, fingers crossed, everything's good. I'll get the new pack tomorrow if there's more updates and we'll play with the Spellcaster save file on Friday and see like what all the new pack can do with it. So I'm excited. So anyways, I'm going to stop rambling. That's it, guys. I will see you guys Friday. Have a good rest of your week. Good night.